This is a day I've dreamed of since I was a young kid. I almost can't believe I've got my hand on the Britten. This is the bike that I dreamed of as a small child, the bike that I had on the wall in my bedroom. It was a revolutionary bike at the time. It won races, it was competitive at the TT, and it was all designed by John Britten and a small team here in New Zealand. It was using technology that nobody had ever thought of or seen. It was a bespoke, beautifully stunning, fast bike. And today, I'm gonna get the opportunity to ride it. Dreams do come true. It's difficult to explain the complexity of this bike. You could write a book on just the forks, for example, which are actually forks. You've got to imagine that nothing was bought off the shelf. They didn't phone up Dymag and buy some wheels. They didn't phone up Ducati and get an engine. The engine is all designed by John Britten and his team. Take the exhaust, for example. Now, the guys had to design the exhaust by hand with a bit of pencil and a paper. So they drew it, worked out the dimensions, worked out the gas flow, worked out how it would perform with their engine that they designed. Then they have to work out the material, the pipe routing, all done by John and his team. 60 hours of man hours just to make the exhaust, to get this perfect shape and perfect performance. Just that part of the bike is incredible, and that is mirrored throughout the bike. John and his team had a philosophy that everything had to do two jobs. So take the top yoke, for example. It's not just a top yoke, that holds on the master cylinder for the front brake. As you know, the radiator and everything comes through and under the seat, but the catch tank is also the overflow bottle, so that does two jobs. The dash is pretty simple, carbon fibre, all built by John, all built by hand, and it holds the clocks. But it also holds a little bottle for the preload adjustment on the front suspension, which means you can change the suspension as you're going along. And this was in the early 90s. It was a massive advantage over the other teams. Only today, 20 years on, a manufacturer is now being able to change the suspension as you're moving. But John was doing this and thinking about this in the early 90s. Again, John didn't conform with normal bike design. He didn't go for a single shock on the back and conventional telescopic forks on the front. In actual fact, this is the rear shock at the front, which is away from all the heat and keeps the bike stable. Connected to the swinging arm via a rod across the bottom, swinging arm, carbon fibre, again designed by John and the team. The front suspension is a single shock, similar to a BMW telelever suspension, all requiring very complex linkage. You can change the rake and the trail just by taking out an Allen key and slightly moving the linkage, which will completely change the steering and characteristics of the bike. Again, this is just mind-blowing kind of design in the early 90s. People had not even thought of this. This was space-age technology. Thank you.
and drop it.
Back in.
Thanks, give us a hand.
No problem, Alan.
You want to keep it? You want to take it back as hand luggage?
Today has been an emotional roller coaster of a day. I still have to pinch myself to believe that I managed to ride the Britten. I'm part of a very, very select group. Obviously, we didn't ride the bike flat out. It's worth a million New Zealand dollars. What I can say is the engine is still impressive. It'll lift the front in third gear if you want it. The brakes are as good as a modern day sports bike like a Panigale, and it's light and it's turns and it's nimble. But I've only scratched the surface of what this bike can do. Today, has been all about celebrating what this bike was and what it is. It's a sad shame that the bike can never be replicated, but I feel very privileged to have ridden it today.